Maitri Gagi with the scholars. And if you look at Mahabharata, Subhadra, Arjuna's wife, went with him to the wars. And Kaikeyi in Ramayana went with Dasharatha, and that's how she got her special boons later. And you look at our deities, all forms of gods are worshipped, most of them in the forms of female. To start with Lakshmi, Saraswati, and end in Parvati. And every form of Lakshmi, Dhairya Lakshmi, Dhanya Lakshmi, Gaja Lakshmi, Ashwa Lakshmi. And Parvati is the power, who has the power of creation and also the power of destruction. And look at the concept of Ardhanarishwara, it's such a beautiful concept. Ishwara is worshipped as half woman and half man. So we as a culture in India, we worship women. So we said, Yatra Naryastu Pujyante, Ramyante Tatra Devataha. Wherever women are worshipped, gods are happy. This was our culture. And somewhere along the line, I think all over the world, women's position slipped. Not only India, also abroad you can see, even in European culture, women became confined to the four walls of their house. They all practically became like slaves of men, like a property. A woman could be married off at any age. They made deals. We become business partners, okay, you marry my daughter. Whatever is the age, doesn't matter. So women became subordinates of men in most of the cultures, not only India. But in the last few decades, this has changed. Of course, we thank the British for so many developments. Whether we had British or not, I think we would have still come out of it, because this awakening is happening all over the world about women's equality. So instead of women being subordinates, women are rising everywhere, and women are walking into many areas of life. And when I look at my own life, I should say I had a very humble beginning, and I always thank my parents who are responsible for my upbringing. My parents were teachers. My father, in fact, was just SSLC when he was married, and later with four children. Every child he did his education. With the first child he did his intermediate, later he did his BA, later he did his MA. So by the time his fourth child was born, he was a professor in the college. And my mom was a teacher, and both of them together shared all the work at home. They never did tuitions, etc. So after the school, the time was devoted to us children. I think we had a very beautiful upbringing. We had a very tight financial budget. Today also I have a lot of value for money. When somebody, a patient tells me, what is the cost of the consultation fee? Can you bring it down? I'm a laborer, I'm a teacher. I know that, how difficult it is to make that money. So we had a very tight budget in the house. But we enjoyed the love of our parents, the quality time was given to us. And my parents told me that if you do not study, you have not much in life. Now you do well, and then you can be a doctor or engineer, whatever you are.